Namaste dear children, welcome to Deeksha Online Bridge course. Subject is physics and today's topic of discussion is graphs. I understand our previous session, which was related to vectors, was heavily loaded and too many things to learn. They were new, we found it little tough and heavy. So today's class, I will try to keep it light. We will discuss about graphs. Most of it you are familiar about. In today's session, I will try to explain to you all how these mathematical graphs can be used in physics. Let us see some of the familiar graphs. Yes, it is a straight line. To plot a straight line graph, initially I take a coordinate axis, x and y axis. If also z axis is included, it will be called as a three-dimensional graph. To plot a straight line, minimum of 3 points are required, which are collinear. Now, to generate a graph of a straight line, a linear equation of the form, let's say 2y is equal to 3x minus 1, a equation like this may be given. You will prepare a table and assign some value for x. On assigning a value of x, you will get a value of y. For those corresponding x and y values, you can plot the graph of a straight line. Next, we would have discussed about the graph of a parabola. The parabola has a vertex here. If you look at the graph, let's say I mark a point x equal to 1 and x equal to minus 1. For both these values of x, you observe the value of y remains the same. That means I get an idea y depends on x as square. So that when I put x equal to 1 or minus 1, when I put x equal to minus 2 or plus 2, the value will remain the same. If I put plus 2, y will be equal to 4. Even if I put minus 2, y will be equal to plus 4. Such a diagram will be symmetric with respect to y-axis. If you go in depth of the parabola, you get a parabola symmetric about x, minus y, minus x. The vertex now is at the origin. It may be at some other point as well. This is called as exponential graph. This is the graph of x versus e power x, where e is equal to 2.71. When you put x is equal to 1, you are going to get, when x equal to 1, e value will be equal to so much. These are some of the graphs which we may be familiar about. Now, let us see one by one a graph which is learnt in mathematics, how it can be used in physics. First, I will take the straight line. This is the equation of a straight line. It is also called as linear equation. Y equal to mx plus c. X and y are variables. When I assign the value of x, the value of y will change according to this equation. M is called as the slope of the straight line. C is called as the y-intercept. So when I plot a graph of this straight line, this is x-axis, this is y-axis. I need not tell, in the equation, you are going to keep applying the values of x and get the value of y. You will be generating this equation. So here, in the equation, whenever the value of x equal to 0, in this equation, when I put x equal to 0, y will become m into 0 plus c. Therefore, y equal to c. This value is called as y-intercept. So, when I put x equal to 0, this is the value of y. This is called as y-intercept. In the same way, this straight line is inclined to the x-axis at an angle theta. This is called as angle of inclination. Tan of this angle theta gives you the slope of the straight line. It is represented by m. Sometimes, if theta is not given, you can complete a triangle anywhere. Call this as A, P, Q. Then, tan theta is given by QP divided by AP, opposite by adjacent side. You can find the slope. So, you understand, the characteristic of the straight line is not only defined by x and y, they are also defined by the y-intercept and the slope. Let us understand even more in detail. Suppose in the linear equation, I have y equal to mx minus c. Here, the y-intercept is negative. Look at the diagram here. The straight line intercepts with the y-axis at a negative value along the negative y-axis. That is why y-intercept is negative. Now, in this equation, I have minus m. That means the slope of the straight line is negative. That is, tan theta has a negative value. If you look at the quadrant system, in the first quadrant, all trigonometric values are positive, whereas in the second quadrant, sine and cosine are, in the second quadrant, sine and cosecant are positive. In the third quadrant, tan and cot are positive. And in the fourth quadrant, cosine and secant are positive. So, you observe in the second quadrant, sine alone is positive, your tan is negative. That means the slope m should be negative. That is why you observe the angle of inclination is greater than 90 degrees. This indicates the slope of the straight line is negative. Now look at the equation of the straight line. Y equal to mx plus c. How can I use this equation in physics? Here, look at x, look at y. X is a variable. It is called as independent variable. It changes by its own. Whereas, y is also a variable, but it depends on x. It is called as dependent variable. Its value depends on the value of x. As x changes, the y value will also change. And m and c will remain a constant. Let me take for example some equations in physics. You are familiar with the Newton's law of gravitation. F equal to g m1 m2 divided by r square. Let's say in this equation, mass of the planet changes. It changes by itself. This changes by itself. This changes by itself. They are all called as independent variables. Whereas, the force between them depends on all of this. You change any one of them, force will change. we would have studied about Ohm's law. V is equal to R into I. When the given physical conditions are constant, R is constant. When I change the value of V, I value will change. So here there is a slight difference in the equation. Here V is independent. I depends on V value. I can set the value of V by using a battery. In the battery, I can set 1 volt, 2 volt, 2.5 volt, 3 volt, any value depending on the device. When I change V, automatically the current in the circuit will change. So the current depends on voltage. So in physics, when I have one quantity varying with the other, I can try to link it with one of the graphical equation and understand the study of the physical quantity. So let us take some examples. In physics, where and all do we come across equation of a straight line? So in the motion in 1D, we have the equation V equal to u plus at, where u is called as initial velocity, a is called as uniform acceleration, because 1D equations are applicable only when the body is traveling in a straight line with uniform acceleration. U and a are constant. I rearrange the equation as V equal to at plus u. So I can rewrite it as y equal to mx plus c. My dear kids, can you correlate the two equation? Instead of y, I have v. So that means in the y axis, I will represent v. In the x axis, I will represent t. With the time, the velocity of the body is changing. Can you tell me what is the independent variable here? Time. What is the dependent variable here? Velocity. Very good. A and u are constant. U is called as y-intercept. Whenever time is equal to 0, in that equation, v becomes equal to u. This is called as initial velocity. Here, whatever is the y-intercept will be your initial velocity. Actually, the graph will start here. I have extrapolated the line here so that I can get the angle theta. You don't get negative time. Negative time is not possible. I have extended the straight line to get the angle theta. When I get the angle theta, acceleration will be given by the slope of the straight line. It is equal to tan theta. What if I cannot extrapolate the line? Then I can draw a triangle somewhere here. Call this as P, call this as Q, call this as R. This angle theta and this angle theta will be equal. Tan theta can also be calculated by finding the length of opposite side and the length of the adjacent side. This is the graphical representation of the motion of a body along a straight line when you know V, E, V, U, A and T. One more example. What happens when a body is thrown up? When a body is thrown up, you see its velocity will keep on decreasing. So I am going to introduce a negative sign for acceleration. And because it is moving under the influence of gravity, A is replaced by minus G. What do you identify this? If you compare with one of the equations I showed you earlier, M is negative. Slope is negative, implies theta is greater than 90 degree. So hence your angle is obtuse angle. For instance, I don't know this particular equation. Only the graph is given. How do we identify whether the acceleration is positive or negative? So in the x-axis I have time, in the y-axis I have velocity. Because theta is greater than 90, the angle is in the second quadrant, tan is negative, slope is given by, in the equation, slope is given by acceleration, so acceleration will be negative. So my dear kids, understand this is a very, very important point. For a body thrown upwards, the graph would look like this. Same way, when a body is dropped, when it is dropped at a time equal to zero, its velocity is equal to zero. With the time, its velocity will keep on increasing. Now you see the theta value is lesser than 90. Now because the body is coming down, acceleration is treated to be positive, so your slope will be positive. I hope this is clear to all of you. Let us look into some more examples. You would be familiar with Ohm's law. Ohm's law states the current through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference across the ends of the conductor when temperature and other physical conditions are constant. So when you compare, remove this proportion symbol, introduce a constant and compare it with the equation of a straight line. I is equal to 1 by R times V. Instead of the proportion symbol, I have introduced resistance. I will add 0 so that I can compare it with Y equal to MX plus C. Here, as I told earlier, V is independent variable, I is the dependent variable. Dependent variable will come along y-axis, independent will come along the x-axis. So you observe the y-intercept of the straight line is zero, so that is why it starts at the origin. And you look at the slope. If you find the slope of the graph, suppose they tell this is equal to 30 degree. How do I find the slope? M is equal to tan 30. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3. According to the equation, what does M represent here? M represents 1 by R. So, this implies 1 by R is equal to 1 by root 3, or R is equal to root 3 ohms. This is called as Ohm's law. I hope you understood that equation of a straight line can be used in physics to represent the variation of one physical quantity with the variation of the other. One more equation similar to what we studied in Ohm's law. Suppose I have a string fixed at the top and I am going to keep on adding the weight. When I keep on adding the weight in the string, the stress will keep on changing. The relation between stress and whatever strain is given to that is given by Hooke's law. According to Hooke's law, stress is directly proportional to strain. Stress is proportional to strain. The proportional symbol is called as modulus of elasticity. So this can be rewritten as stress is equal to a constant times strain plus zero. As strain, external force increases, stress also will increase. If I choose this as y, m, x plus zero. So the graph will be a straight line passing through the origin because y-intercept is equal to 0. My dear kids, this law for the entire of the region for all values of strain, the graph wouldn't be a straight line. It will remain a straight line only up to a certain level, beyond which the straight line may become a curve like this. It depends on the nature of the material, which is represented by modulus of elasticity. When you come to PU, we are going to discuss about this. Where will we require stress and the strain? Suppose you are sitting on the swing, or when you are playing tug of war, you cannot use the same string for all. You need to choose a string with a suitable modulus of elasticity which can withstand proper stress and strain. And also in the crane is trying to lift the load. Those strings should have suitable stress to strain ratio which can be worked out through the graph. We'll move on. Another example for equation of straight line in physics is the variation of resistance with temperature. According to this equation, R is the resistance of the conductor at a temperature equal to T. R naught is the resistance of the conductor at a temperature equal to 0 degree Celsius, and alpha is called as a constant. It is called as coefficient of resistance or temperature coefficient of resistance. This relation, if I rearrange, I will get this equation: R naught into alpha T, R naught into 1. I have written like this. As temperature changes, R will also change. So, a graph, when it is plotted with the temperature along the x-axis, resistance along the y-axis, you observe the y-intercept equal to R naught. What do you mean by y-intercept? In my diagram, when T equal to 0 degree, whatever is the resistance is called as y-intercept. That is what is represented here. Now, by looking at the slope of the graph, compare it with the equation of the straight line, y equal to mx plus c. Your slope, m is equal to R naught into alpha. You will get the value of alpha by studying the graph. My dear kids, what is the use of plotting such a graph? You see, attaining 0 degree Celsius, 0 degree Celsius itself is a challenge in the household. If I extrapolate the graph, it is observed that it will come and meet at minus 272 point some small value degree Celsius. Experimentally, attaining these smaller values lesser than 0 degree might be a challenge. Instead of performing an experiment, you can understand the study of the resistance of the conductor at different temperature. At this temperature, you can estimate the resistance would be so much. At this temperature, the resistance may be so much. You can identify the unknown values by plotting the graph. This is what was done by Kemmerling Onnes. With the same equation, he expected the line to reach minus 272. But when he was doing experiment with mercury, he observed that when the temperature reached around 4.2 Kelvin, or it reached a value equal to minus 269 degrees Celsius, He found that the resistance of mercury did not obey this equation. Suddenly, the resistance fell to zero. This led to the discovery of the phenomenon called as superconductivity. Going forward, next type of the graph, parabola. Parabola can be generated by this particular equation where the dependent variable changes with the independent variable x according to the relation ax square plus bx plus c is equal to y. Sometimes if b and c are equal to 0, you are going to get this equation. For that equation, the graph would look like this. This is called as the parabola. As I told you earlier, this will be called as the vertex. While plotting the graph, you would have taken x and you would have taken y along the axis. For each value of I, there are two possible values of x. One is positive, the other one is negative. When you square the negative term, you are going to get the positive value for y. Where will I get parabola in physics? This graph is also typically a parabola generated by this equation. You may get this in equation of motion, 2D motion. When a body is thrown at an angle theta with a velocity equal to v, the body will move along a parabolic path and come over here. The equation of this trajectory is given by y equal to ax square plus b into x. As x value, the displacement along the x-axis is changing, the displacement along the y-axis will also change. This graph you are going to study in 2D motion. So I am trying to repeat that the parabolic equation is required to study the 2D motion, and the equation of parabola is so much. While studying POC, your teacher, while doing motion in 2D, they will derive an equation and arrive at this path, and they will ask in the class, what does this equation represent? Now tell me what will be the path of the body taken. While doing the derivation, they would have just thrown the body at an angle theta with a velocity equal to v naught. After doing a derivation, they arrive at this step and try to understand what would be the path taken. I want you all to answer, sir, this is the equation of the parabola. Therefore, the particle will take a parabolic path and come down. The next equation is inverse of x, y equal to 1 by x. Let us understand this graph. This is very, very important in physics. According to this equation, let me substitute the value of x to be equal to 0. Then what happens to y? Y will be equal to 1 by 0. Anything by 0 equal to infinity. So in the equation, in the graph, when I put x equal to 0, y value is infinity. That is why you observe here, the graph is not touching the y-axis. They have almost become parallel to each other. That means the graph is going to meet the y-axis at infinity. Then what happens? Then as x value increases, y value will keep on decreasing. Suppose I put x equal to 1. Y will become equal to 1. So when x value is equal to 1, y value will also be equal to 1. When x keeps on increasing, let's say x is equal to 2, y will become 1 by 2. So the graph comes out to be somewhere here. As x increases, y value will keep on decreasing. But you should understand, y will become 0 only when x becomes equal to infinity, because anything by infinity is equal to 0. That is why, again here, you observe the graph has become parallel to the x-axis. It indicates the graph will touch the x-axis at infinity and become 0 at infinity. This understanding is required for physics. In AC circuits, while discussing the current, you have a capacitor. A capacitor is a device used to store the charge. When I connect this to a battery, the charges tend to flow, giving rise to a current. This is the flow of charge. Current will be like this. For the flow of the current, the capacitor will give an opposition. The opposition given by the capacitor is called as XC. It varies with the frequency of AC. AC has a frequency, or 2 pi f is equal to omega. As you all know, household appliances work on a AC of frequency 50 hertz. F is equal to 50. How does the opposition given by the capacitor for the current? Earlier we discussed about R. R is the resistance offered by the conductor. Here, the same thing offered by the capacitor is represented by XC. It is called as capacitive reactance. How does this vary with the frequency of AC, either F or omega? The equation of XC is equal to 1 by omega into C. If I keep 1 by C as a constant into 1 by omega, you see this is an inverse equation. When omega equal to 0, XC will be infinity, that is why they are parallel. As omega increases, XC value will keep on decreasing, and again it will become parallel to the x-axis. This is inverse of x. Next we will discuss y is equal to e power x. This is called as exponential function. These type of equations are also popular in physics. So to plot a graph based on this equation, first let me put x equal to 0. When I put x equal to 0, anything power 0 equal to 1. So when I put x equal to 0, y value is equal to 1. When I put x is equal to 1, y will become equal to e. E is called as Euler number. It is called as Euler number. It is around 2.7. When I put x is equal to 1, the value of E that I get will be equal to 2.71. And after that, as I keep on increasing the value of x, y value will keep on increasing. What if instead of e power x, I have e power minus x? This is actually 1 by e power x. How does this graph look like? In this graph, when I put x is equal to 0, anything power 0 equal to 1. So when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 1. So when x equal to 0, y equal to 1. And after that, as x value keeps on increasing, you observe there is a negative of x. That means x is increasing in the denominator. Y value will keep on decreasing. Hence, the graph goes like this. Again, when x reaches infinity, anything power infinity is zero. Therefore, I have made the two graph and the x-axis to be parallel to each other. This equation comes in radioactivity. N is equal to n naught e power minus lambda into t. There, we will have time along the x-axis and number of nuclei in the y-axis. When I put t equal to 0 here, anything power 0 equal to 1, the number of nuclei will become equal to n naught. So that is why this value turns out to be n naught when time equal to 0. And with time, because there is a radioactive decay, the number of nuclei will keep on decreasing. We will move to the next, but the last graph for today's discussion. It is called as a sine function or a cosine function. It's a graph of y is equal to sine theta. Now let me take, for example, a table with theta value and y value. When theta equal to 0, sine 0 equal to 0, I get this point. When theta is equal to 90 degrees, sine 90 is equal to 1, I get this point. This is at theta equal to 90. If you want to represent it in SI system, you can call it as pi by 2. So here, either you can write t or theta. T, I will tell you when to write it. When theta becomes 180, sine 180 is 0, so you get this point. So from 0 to 180 degree, the graph doesn't go straight because in between values will be 1 by 2, 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2. They are not in a straight line. Join them, you will get a uniform curve like this. Beyond 180, at 270, sine 270 is minus 1 and 360 is equal to 0. So you get this part of the curve. After that, when you go beyond 360 degree, the graph will repeat. This is called as sine function or sinusoidal function. This type of graph is available in physics under the topic called as simple harmonic motion, or even for AC circuits, we will come across this equation and the graph. So, in the equation for simple harmonic motion, y is equal to A is the maximum value. Let me give A is equal to, let's say, 3 into sine omega t. With time it is changing, or I can take theta itself. Then here at this point, when theta is 0, sine 0 is 0, y will be 0. But when theta is equal to 90, sine 90 is 1, your y value will be equal to 3. This peak value is called as the amplitude of simple harmonic motion. This type of graph, as I told you, you will get to see in simple harmonic motion and AC circuits. Wherever you have sine function, this type of graph will be obtained. A similar type of a graph can be obtained for cosine also. Let us try for cosine function. For the cosine function, y is equal to A cos theta. This is also an equation of simple harmonic motion. If I put theta is equal to 0, 90, 180, 270 and 360. Cos, this is y. When I put theta equal to 0, cos 0 equal to 1, 1 into a will be a. cos 90 is 0, cos 180 is minus 1, minus 1 into A, cos 270 is 0, cos 360 is 1, 1 into A is A. So when I plot a graph of theta along the x-axis and y along the y-axis, at theta equal to 0, your y is equal to A. At theta equal to 90, the answer is equal, y value equal to 0. At 180, the value is equal to minus A. Somewhere here, for 270, it is equal to 0. So when I join the graph, I will get something like this. At 360, again it is equal to plus A. The graph will go like this. So if you observe, sine graph and cosine graph will remain the same except for the starting point. In the starting point, at theta equal to 0, sine starts from 0, whereas cos starts with the maximum value. Otherwise, both the graphs are identical. These are some of the graphs that we come across in physics. Let's have a quick recap of what we studied so far. So, first equation what we studied was the equation of a straight line. In the equation of the straight line, y equal to mx plus c. M represents the slope, c represents the y-intercept. Here, y varies with the value of x. In physics, where do we come across such equation? Body thrown up, the body will be moving under the influence of gravity, its velocity decreases, the graph will be straight line like this. Ohm's law graph would look like this, where current in the circuit will vary with the applied voltage according to the equation of a straight line. Again, in mechanics, mechanical property of solids, we will study the stress taken by the object when an external strain acts on it. According to the Hooke's law, the graph will look like a straight line up to a certain level. Then, variation of resistance with temperature is also denoted by a straight line. Then we discussed about the graph of the parabola. The equation of the parabola is so much. You study about this in motion in two dimension, where the body in 2D motion will execute a parabolic path. Then the graph of 1 by x, where at x equal to 0, y value is infinity, they become parallel. And as x increases, y becomes 0 at infinity, again it becomes parallel here. We come across such a graph related to the capacitive reactance of the capacitor, which is nothing but the opposition given by the capacitor for AC current. Then we discussed about exponentially increasing function, exponentially decreasing function. It is used in nuclear physics. Then sine function, y is equal to sine theta. It is sinusoidal function for simple harmonic motion and alternating current. We can use this graph. Cos graph looks like the sine graph itself, except at the starting point, there is a shift in the position. Otherwise, both the graphs are identical. So, with this, I understand that physical quantities can be represented graphically. By doing so, I can get a better understanding of the concept. So let us meet up in the tutorial session and try to plot few more graphs with the knowledge what we gain now. Till that time, take care. Bye.